Well, I hope you watched my first lesson for beginners where we've learned Russian alphabet and some simple words. And it's time now to start simple conversations. Let's learn basic survival phrases and make your first dialogues in Russian. Let's start with the first word. Hello. In Russian, it's привет. Привет. You might have heard it many times, but the mistake I often hear is saying привет instead of привет. Привет. Yes, the letter is е, but we don't say е. In words, the sound is э. We don't say привет, we say привет. Привет. Use it only for friends or people you know really well. Don't use it when you come into the shop or on the street to people you don't know really well, to people you don't know at all. Instead of that, use доброе утро, добрый день, добрый вечер. Добрый means kind or good. And утро means morning. День means day or afternoon here, and вечер means evening. Доброе утро together means good morning. Доброе утро. Утро is a neutral noun. That is why the adjective before that is also neutral. That is why we are saying доброе. Доброе утро. The words день and вечер are masculine nouns. That is why the adjective before them is also masculine. Добрый, добрый, добрый день, добрый вечер. Добрый день, добрый вечер. Again, we don't say д'е, день. No, we say день. We don't say вечер, вечер. No, вечер, вечер. Добрый день, добрый вечер. If you are struggling with the pronunciation, the best thing you can do is to record yourself. Record yourself. Привет, доброе утро, добрый день, добрый вечер. Compare your pronunciation with pronunciation of native speakers. Another super popular greeting is здравствуйте. Здравствуйте. Ooh, it even looks like a terrible animal because so many letters in one word and so many consonants together in one word. So let's practice it very, very slowly. Здравствуйте. Здравствуйте. What is tough here to pronounce z, d, r together? Здра, здра, здра. Да, с, т, в. Ствуйте. Здравствуйте. And as you can see, letter v isn't pronounced here. And many native speakers make mistake here in spelling. So this word is tough even for native speakers. Not for pronunciation, of course, because we grew up with that. But for spelling. Yes, it is. Again. Здравствуйте. Здравствуйте. What can we do with that? We can practice it very, very slowly for several times. Practice it out loud for 5-10 times. If you're still struggling with that, don't worry. Use доброе утро instead, or добрый день, or добрый вечер. That is absolutely fine. By the way, quite a lot of native speakers contract the word здравствуйте and say здрасте, здрасте, здрасте. It sounds the same as здравствуйте, but when we pronounce it very fast. Здрасте. Здрасте. How to choose the greeting? Of course, it depends on a situation. Доброе утро, добрый день, добрый вечер, вечер are all neutral. You can use them with all people in Russia. If you are talking to friends, you can say привет. Like I'm talking at the beginning of my videos, very often I say привет. I don't say здравствуйте. If you don't know exactly or if you are unsure exactly what to say, it's better to say здравствуйте. Okay, it's better to say здравствуйте, or if the pronunciation is difficult, so доброе утро, добрый день, добрый вечер. Привет is only for friends. As for goodbyes, let's learn three variants. Пока is informal one. Пока, пока-пока. You can also say пока-пока. And more formal one is до свидания. До свидания. It sounds, of course, it sounds as one word. And we pronounce it до свидания. До свидания. До свидания. Okay. And the last one is also very common. До встречи. До встречи. Until next time. Встреча is meeting. And so we are saying till meeting, literally. До встречи. До встречи. But again, there are several consonants together in one place. And so that is why до встречи is not very common. It is common for native speakers, but for learners, sometimes it is better to learn just пока или до свидания. Please is пожалуйста. Пожалуйста. We don't pronounce I. We don't say пожалуйста. No, we say пожалуйста. Пожалуйста. And it is used both to respond to thank you. So a person says спасибо, thank you. And you say пожалуйста. And it is also used to ask for something. To say please, please help me. Пожалуйста, помогите мне. Please help me. Пожалуйста, помогите мне. How to say yes, please. Да, пожалуйста. Да is yes. Пожалуйста is please. So we have да, пожалуйста. How to say no, thanks. Нет, спасибо. Нет means no. Нет, спасибо. Спасибо. We pronounce а all the time. Спасибо. But if you spell, if you have to write this word, never say spa, never put down спасибо with а at the end. It is or at the end. It is written as спасибо. Спасибо. And the very common spelling mistake for Russian learners is to write спасибо instead of спасибо. Okay, so keep in mind, we write спасибо, yeah, or we type спасибо, but we say спасибо. Спасибо. Пожалуйста. Excuse me is простите или извините. Простите, we pronounce а, though you can see о. Простите. And извините. Извините. In Russian there is no difference between excuse me and sorry. We use either of them to draw someone's attention or to when we did something wrong. We can say о, простите. Oh, sorry. Or we can draw someone's attention saying простите. Помогите мне, пожалуйста. Help me, please. Помогите мне, пожалуйста. Okay. Простите. Извините. Then also, I used the conjunction here. Простите и извините. So, I think that you already know that, but still. И means and. So, I'm saying простите и извините. Also, I can use the conjunction или. Or или. I can say, you may use простите или Извините. Yeah, I use these conjunctions all the time, so just I think that I needed one moment to translate them. How are you? Is как дела? Дела. Дела are things. Things that we have to do. Things that we have in our life. Like everyday stuff. That what is дела. Как дела? How are things? Как дела? Also, sometimes people ask как жизнь? Жизнь means life. So we are asked, how is your life? How is it going? Как дела? Как жизнь? To respond, we say нормально. Нормально. That is a neutral way. Then we can say хорошо. Good. Хорошо. We pronounce а-а because they are not stressed. That is why not о-о, but а-а. Хорошо. Or we can also say pretty good. Very good. Очень хорошо. Let me ask you. Как дела? What would you say? Нормально, хорошо или очень хорошо? Как дела? Хорошо. Or как дела? Нормально. Как дела? Очень хорошо. And then we say а у тебя and you. А у тебя. А у тебя как дела? And you. Меня зовут Альфия. Меня зовут Альфия. А тебя как тебя зовут? What's your name? Как тебя зовут? So, I'm asking you now, what's your name? And you're answering, okay? So, как тебя зовут? Меня зовут. Меня зовут and your name. Perfect. After you tell me your name, I would say приятно познакомиться. Nice to meet you. Great to meet you. Приятно. Приятно means pleased. Приятно. Ятно. Приятно. Познакомиться. Познакомиться. Приятно познакомиться. Nice to meet you. If you want to know where somebody is from, you ask откуда ты? Where are you from? Откуда ты? Откуда ты? And you answer я из, and then comes the place where you come from. Я из, and then comes the name of the city, the name of the country, whatever you want to say. The thing is, you have to change that name of the place, of the country, of the city. Because in Russian, it should be in genitive case. It is called genitive case, when we change the ending of the object. But if you are just traveling or going to travel around Russia, don't care. Everybody will understand you. If you are learning Russian and want to sound grammatically correct, yes, you have to put the name of the object in genitive case. So I would say я из России. Я из России. I'm from Russia. Откуда ты? Now I'm asking you. Откуда ты? Я из. And say the name of the city. Whatever it is. Now let's learn a phrase. Sorry, I don't speak Russian. It will be извините, я не говорю по-русски. Извините, я не говорю по-русски. Let's practice it slowly. Извините, я не говорю по-русски. Извините, я не говорю по-русски. Извините means sorry. Я не говорю means I don't speak. По-русски means Russian. If you speak Russian a little, and I'm sure you do. You say, я говорю по-русски. Or, if you speak a little, я немного, немного means a little. You put it before the word говорю, speak. Я немного говорю по-русски. Or you can also say, я чуть-чуть. Чуть-чуть means a little. Я чуть-чуть говорю по-русски. You might be wondering if a person speaks your language. For example, English. You may ask, ты говоришь по-английски? Then comes the language you're asking about. По-английски means English. Ты говоришь по-английски? Or ты говоришь по, and then your language, по-итальянски. Ты говоришь по-французски. Now let's revise what we've learned. I'm asking you, как тебя зовут? You say, меня зовут, and your name. Откуда ты? Where are you from? Я из, and the name of the place. Ты говоришь по-русски? You say, да, я говорю по-русски. Or, да, я чуть-чуть говорю по-русски. And I guess knowing these words are pretty good for you for your first time in Russia or your first couple of weeks in Russia. Learn them by heart. Read them out loud 10 times in a row. And if you want more, check out my Russian for Beginners playlist. There will be a lot of lessons on Russian vocabulary and grammar for beginners. And if you want some more intensive practice, come to my Skype lessons. Пока!